out with the old, in with the new. Here they are, the rookie class of 2020, who may have to wait a little bit longer than normal to take the practice field, but they are one step closer to solidifying their position on the Jacksonville Jaguars roster. How did they do that, you say? Well, how about some numbers? Everybody loves numbers. 12 new rookies bringing 12 new numbers, and quite a bit of conversation as well. I know Kalavon Chaisson went on Twitter to find out what his new number was going to be, and the fans voted 45. Interesting number for a defensive end, but 41 worked well for Josh Allen, so why not, right? The highlight of the first group, without question, C.J. Henderson, the former Gator, took to Twitter, shooting down the chance of being the new face of number 20. Instead, he will wear number 21. Number 20, meanwhile, there he is right there, Daniel Thomas. The second group belongs to another big group of digits. How about the number 50, which certainly may be in need of a makeover? The man tasked with that, the hometown kid, Shaq Quarterman, straight out of Oakleaf. And here's an interesting one for you, by the way. Chris Claybrooks, if I'm his family, don't go buy a number 7 jersey. If you're a fan, do not go buy a number 7 jersey. That is a placeholder, because he is not allowed to be number 7 in the NFL. He can in training camp, and then once the team gets whittled down to 53, he can change his number. But right now, he's number 7, which is a number he's legally not allowed to wear in the NFL, unless he's a kicker, punter, or quarterback. He's not any of those things. One more name to watch. How about that guy? There he is. He's pointing at me. I pointed at him. That's Colin Johnson, the 6'6" wide receiver out of Texas. Our own Brent Martineau catching up with the new face of the number 19 earlier this week.
First and goal of the 2. Little Jordan Humphrey in the end zone to Colin Johnson.
You know, definitely still feeling the emotions, but just not the way you feel it on the first day when you get the call and then everyone's calling your phone afterwards and you're just trying to soak it all in and there's just so much going on. I'm just excited to get to work and excited to be there, and I can't wait. Jacksonville sounds like an amazing place to play, and I can't wait to get in there, and I promise they're going to get everything I got.
I guess we feel around here like, hey, 6'6" guy, that's a red zone guy to start. And then who knows where it goes from there. But you get the sense that, I mean, that is what you bring to the NFL, at least in the immediate.
I think in the immediate, you know, for sure, you can't teach 6'6", you know. And I remember talking to my agent, talking to my family, and they kept saying, whoever drafts you is going to have a plan for you. Because being 6'6", some teams overlook that and don't like that, and some teams like that. But whoever drafts me is going to have a plan for me. So I'm trusting, you know, they're going to have a plan for me, whether it's in the red zone or whatever. But right now, my main focus is to make the team. I want to make the 53-man roster, and I'll do whatever it takes.
Have you heard from Minshew yet?
I have. Right when I got drafted, he actually texted me. When I saw Minshew, I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. He reached out this early. So that honestly, you know, meant a lot to me, but I'm just excited to get to work with him. And that's what I said. I said, thank you for the congratulations, and I can't wait to get to work.
Let's it go.
Somebody put like a 5-minute highlight reel out of you. But what really jumped out at me was the Gus Johnson calls. Is a Gus Johnson called highlight better than a regular touchdown or a regular catch?
Oh, man. Yeah, he makes me look a lot better than I probably am with him announcing. He's screaming. It'll be like a simple first down catch, and he'd be like, Johnson!
Delivers! Oh, Gus, drag of the 45.
He was definitely a fun one. He was probably my favorite announcer in college for sure.
Yeah, he's about everybody's favorite announcer in college. For more long-form interviews as well as full broadcasts from ESPN 690, go check out our YouTube page. All you got to do is search for Action Sports Jacks. Included in there is our draft evaluations, where the entire comment section agrees that we are idiots. Isn't the internet great, folks? Just love it. It's fun. Next up on the NFL schedule, well, it's not rookie camp with that going the virtual route. Instead, it's the schedule release, which is expected to come on Thursday night. The NFL announcing that it'll release the full 17-week schedule with no changes expected and fans part of the fold when the season gets started. Of course, that part very much up in the air. I'm going to be really interested to see the London announcement, if those games are still on, considering all the intricacies of international travel. So two of those home games right now slated to go to London. We'll see, because Europe's been a little more strict when it comes to reopening things than they have here in the States.
Action Sports Jacks Primetime, Saturday at 10:30 on Fox 30.